Hi, today I'm going to show you how to start your first project in Trae IDE. This is the video you want to watch if you just get started. As you can see, Trae has the familiar look of an IDE like VS Code, where you can find folders on the left, and on the right side is where you can get started by just chatting with AI. You can either start left or start right by getting ideas ready from 0 to 1 with your agent. Let's start in a traditional way first. You can open an existing folder in Trae by open a folder in your local or clone a GitHub repository, or you can also connect with remote host. Let's start by opening up our Trae agent repository. So after you open up your file, you can always connect to your remote SSH from here. Now let's chat with AI to start editing a file. So we open up this Anthropic API client wrapper. And here, as you can see, there are several ways you can do it. You can either edit inline, or you can add this class to the chat, and then start working with Trae on this class. So another feature that can help you edit faster is our context understanding agent called Q. So just with one tab, it can help you with multi-line edits, smart refactoring, and also cursor predictions. So for example, if we change name to this content block, so with one tap, we can apply the name change for all the variables in this file. Let's move on to the right side. So for here, you can select the models that you want to work with. You can also add custom models and bring your own key in your work. Now here's a lot of people might miss for the first time. Now we are still in the chat mode. And if you want to switch to using an agent, you have to add an agent from here. We have two in-house agents. One is called Builder, where you can access file systems, terminals, web search, and see previews using this agent. Another agent is called Builder with MCP, which utilizes all the MCPs as tools when you call upon this agent. And you can also create your own custom agents like I do by giving the agent a name, a prompt to define its roles and tones, and also select tools that this custom agent might be able to use. In Trae, we try to understand you and your code better by providing rich options of context. So here's how you can add context and manage your context. So the first thing you will see is our codebase indexing. Right now, it looks like our workspace is successfully indexed, and you can always rebuild when you want to. If there are some files like API keys or sensitive environment information that you don't want to be indexed, you can add to ignore files. These files will be ignored by Trae when indexing your repo. Besides, we support adding common docs through URLs or local uploads as context for AIs to be understand. You can add your best practices here. Right now, we added a project guideline for this Trae agent project. So in Trae, we also support adding different kinds of rules. If you go to rules, here user rules define the usage preferences, such as the output languages or the default behaviors in your personal workspace in Trae. And project rules are more specific to the project. You can create project-specific guidelines to let Trae know what should follow when working on the current repository. Last but not least, you can add different kind of MCPs as tools for your work. So here you can see that I added different MCPs for my custom agents. You can always add manually if you have some MCPs to be configured, or you can add from our MCP marketplace. We are actively updating this marketplace with the most up-to-date MCP tools in the market. And if you're done with your work and want to make a Git commit, you don't have to type it yourself right now. Trae can generate commit messages for you. And if that looks good, you can click and commit. Okay, so now I want to ask the builder to add the Grok API for me. Let's get into this. Okay, it looks like it's trying to understand the structures and the patterns and then starting to work on my requirements. Okay, it looks like it's done adding a Grok client in our code base. Let's take a look. All right, looks good. Okay, I'll just accept it. And here we can submit a code review. Cool, so Trae just generated a commit message for me. All right, that's all for today's video. Hope you like it.